Welcome to Christchurch Daily Reflections for Advent. I'm Geoff Roberts. Today's reflection focuses on the second of the patriarchs, Isaac. Isaac, son of Abraham, one whose name variously translates as he is God, which is the expression that Abraham and Sarah used when, despite all human realities, they were blessed with him as a son. The other translation is the laughing one, reflecting the joy of Abraham and Sarah at the miracle of Isaac's birth when Sarah was way, way, way past childbearing age. In both Old and New Testaments, God is called the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. So there is no doubting the significance of the patriarchs. But why? Well, let's look at Isaac. The most familiar story about him is when Abraham, his father, took him, his treasured son, and was prepared to sacrifice him in total obedience to God. And incidentally, when I was reading around this passage, I realized that the Jewish historian Josephus put Isaac at 25 when he was to be offered as a sacrifice. Not the young child we generally see portrayed in children's Bibles. In fact, the general consensus of all the commentators is that he was a young man, not a boy. After all, as they climb the mountain, he's the one that's carrying a heavy load of wood necessary for a sacrifice. Not a young boy. And the fact that he was strong enough to carry that wood up the mountain indicates he was probably strong enough to fend off Abraham to resist being sacrificed if he'd wanted to. But the fact that he allowed himself to be bound and placed on the altar shows that amazing trust that Isaac had in his earthly father. I have to admit, I never had that sort of trust in my father, not anywhere close. And Isaac's trust foreshadows what was the key aspect of his life and the aspect that we should celebrate, his trust in God. But the first point to make is that for all this amazing backstory, that having Abraham as a father, seeing a goat amazingly appear ready for the sacrifice instead of him, he was human. He was certainly not perfect. As we look at the story of his life, we see the plus side. He, unlike even the other patriarchs, had only one wife. But then on the negative side, in Genesis 26, verse 7, he is, should we say, economical with the truth, to say the least, because he tells the men of Gerar that his wife Rebekah is his sister. And he did this because he was afraid that if he claimed her as his wife, they might decide to kill him to get to her. Well, as we read on, he was found out about that by Abimelech and did settle down and prospered. In fact, he prospered so much that the Philistines became jealous and he was asked to leave. And then we get back to the plus side again. It is clear that in his living there and in his leaving, he trusted God. In 26, verse 22, he says, "For now the Lord has made room for us, and we shall be faithful, fruitful in the land." So we have a pattern. And this is the pattern of the patriarchs. People with a relationship of God's promise and purpose fixed in their hearts. This promise is made absolutely clear in the verse for today, verse 24. "And the Lord appeared to him in the same night and said, 'I am the God of Abraham, your father. Fear not, for I am with you and will bless you and multiply your offspring for my servant Abraham's sake.'" Now Isaac continued to live out his life trusting in that promise. We've already seen how he trusted his earthly father, how much more he trusted God. So if that's the example of Isaac, what about us? Well, the Lord appeared to Isaac in the night and made an amazing promise, a promise of blessing. And actually, we are left with an even more incredible advantage. Because in this season of Advent, we look to the Savior of the world coming to us and making the promise of blessing, the promise of forgiveness for sin, the promise of eternal life, the promise of salvation, a reality for all who put their trust in him. Now that's really amazing. And like the game show host would say, and there's more. See, when Jesus went back to heaven, he sent the Holy Spirit to live in all of us who are Christians, to guide us and to help us. Unlike Isaac, we don't just have the occasional visit from God. We have the person of the Holy Spirit living in us, confirming each day God's love and promise for us, confirming each day our purpose here on earth. And just to be clear, what is our purpose? Well, it's easy. It is to share the good news of Jesus Christ with all we meet, to show in our lives that we have the same relationship of promise and purpose in our lives that the patriarchs had. Isaac was a tremendous example of trust, trust in his father, Abraham, trust in God. Now we have the advantage of knowing part two of the Bible story, the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus, and the gift of the Holy Spirit. So let's step out in that trust, step out in faith, sharing God's message of hope and salvation, of love, so that all we do glorifies God. Let's pray. Father God, thank you for the example of the amazing trust of Isaac. Help us, Lord, to trust you in all that we say and do, no matter what the circumstances. Help us to show your love to others in thought and word and deed. Amen. Now, I have been a bit cheeky and chosen two songs. One is a very simple, familiar one, Trust and Obey. And the second is newer and one I've only just discovered, I Will Trust in You by Elevation Worship. Have a lovely day and God bless.